the problems. Yesterday we have done some problems. Now we will continue with the problems. The first problem for today's session. Drift current in the semiconductor depends on dash. Options are only on electric field. Option A, only on electric field. Option B, only on concentration gradient. We'll continue with the problems. Yesterday we have done some problems. Now we'll continue with the problems. The first problem for today's session. Drift current in the semiconductor depends on dash. Options are only on electric field. Option A, only on electric field. Option B, only on concentration gradient. Next option. Both electric field and concentration gradient. I will repeat option C and option D. Option C is both electric field and concentration, means its carrier concentration. Okay. Option D is both an electric field and carrier, concentration gradient. That means the electric current density, and it is a drift current density, depends on. What is the formula for a drift current density? It's n mu n e plus p mu p e electric field. So it depends on E, that is electric field compulsory. Now what about this N and this P? They are carrier concentrations. That's electron concentration and hole concentration. Concentration gradient means it's dp by dx, dn by dx. This is called concentration gradient. Carrier concentration means this is called carrier concentration. So the current density, drift current density, depends on electric field and carrier concentration. Carrier concentration and electric field. It is not dependent on concentration gradient. Who will depend on concentration gradient? Diffusion current will depend on concentration gradient. That is E into dN into dN by dx, or minus E into dP dN by dx. Clear? Next problem. The ratio of mobility to the diffusion coefficient. The ratio of mobility to the diffusion coefficient in a semiconductor, has units of dash. That means, what are the units for this one? If you see in the previous session, I gave one formula, dp by mu p equals to dn by mu n is equals to vt. What is vt? It is at room temperature, it is 26 millivolts. Therefore, the units are volts. It's called Einstein relationship. But in the problem, he asked mu by d. Either it mu n by dn or mu p by dp, which is equals 1 by vt. Therefore, it is 1 by volts. Clear? The units are 1 by volts. for a ratio of mobility to the diffusion coefficient, answer is 1 by volts. The next question. The electron and hole concentrations in an intrinsic semiconductor, are Ni per cubic meter centimeter, okay, Ni per centimeter cube at 300 degree Kelvin, at 300 degree Kelvin, okay. Now, once again I am repeating, the electron and hole concentrations in an intrinsic semiconductor are Ni per centimeter cube at 300 degree Kelvin. Now, acceptor impurities are added means N suffix A are added with a concentration of Na per cubic. He is not given values, he is directly given Ni and Na. Then, electron concentration per cubic centimeter H, that means he is asking the electron concentration per cubic centimeter at 300 degree Kelvin will be dash. Options are Ni plus Na, Na minus Ni, Ni square by Na. Now, intrinsic concentration is Ni, acceptor impurities are added. Then, we know mass action law. N into P equals to Ni square. It is applicable for N-type semiconductor, P-type semiconductor and intrinsic semiconductor. Now we are adding acceptor impurities means it becomes a P-type semiconductor. Therefore, P Ni square. In the previous session, we have seen the PP equals to Na. What is PP? Hole concentration in P-type semiconductor is equals to Na. Therefore, what he asked? Electron concentration in this one, that is Ni square by PP, that is Ni square by Na. So, option is option D. Clear? This is electron concentration, hole concentration. This formula is called mass action law. It is applicable for intrinsic semiconductor, extrinsic semiconductor, nothing but P-type semiconductor and N-type semiconductor. Clear? Next problem. A heavily doped N-type semiconductor, has the following data. What is the data? He is given whole electron mobility ratio. Whole electron mobility ratio is 0.4. Doping concentration 4.2 into 10 power 8 atoms per centimeter cube. Intrinsic concentration, he given N-type impurities. N-type impurities means donor impurities. In the problem he said, a heavily doped N-type semiconductor has the following. Okay, that means doping impurities are donor impurities, ND. ND equals to 4.2 into 10 power 8 atoms per centimeter cube. Intrinsic concentration is 1.5 into 10 power 4 atoms per centimeter cube. Then find the ratio of conductivity of n-type semiconductor to intrinsic semiconductor. Okay. What is the ratio of conductivity of an n-type semiconductor to conductivity of an intrinsic semiconductor? Now, conductivity of an n-type semiconductor is given as n-type semiconductor, majority charge carriers are electrons. So there are no accept impurities, holes are negligible. So this can be written as ND E mu N. Intrinsic concentration, conductivity of intrinsic semiconductor, N mu N E plus P mu P E. Now, intrinsic concentration means it is Ni mu n E plus, this is once again, both in intrinsic semiconductor, electron concentration is equals to hole concentration. Therefore, this can also be written as Ni, that's important one. This P also can be written as Ni, because in intrinsic semiconductor, electron concentration is equals to hole concentration, okay, into mu P into E. Therefore, take Ni and E outside, it is mu N plus mu P. Okay, give it as equation number 1, give it as equation number 2. Therefore, sigma N by sigma I, conductivity of an n-type semiconductor, okay, N D E mu N divided by Ni E mu N plus mu P. E E will cancel. He is given mu P equals to 0.4, mu P by mu N equals to 0.4. Therefore, this can be written as Nd into mu N divided by Nd into mu N divided by Ni mu N as T is plus mu P 0.4 mu N, 0.4 mu N. So this can be written as ND mu N by Ni, mu N take it outside, it 1 plus 0.4, it is 1.4. Therefore, sigma N by sigma I equals to ND by 1.4 into Ni. What is ND? 4.2 into 10 power 8. All are in centimeter cube only. It's 1.4 into Ni. 1.5 into 10 power 4. Okay, substitute and find out the, simplify and find out the values. Okay, value. Next. Next problem. The concentration of minority carriers in an extrinsic semiconductor, under equilibrium is dash. I'm repeating once again. The concentration of minority carriers in an extrinsic semiconductor under equilibrium is dash. Options are directly proportional to doping concentration, inversely proportional to doping concentration. Next one, directly proportional to intrinsic concentration. Next one is inversely proportional to intrinsic concentration. Once again, I am repeating the problem. The concentration of minority carriers in an extrinsic semiconductor under equilibrium is dash. Options are directly proportional to doping concentration, inversely proportional to doping concentration, directly proportional to intrinsic concentration, inversely proportional to intrinsic concentration. I'll take with example, take it is an intrinsic semiconductor. In intrinsic semiconductor, number of electrons is equals to number of holes. Take it as example, 50 electrons plus 50 holes. Now we have added, let us suppose, impurities. Example, donor impurities are added. Now, donor impurities, majority charge carriers are electrons. So, the number of electrons are going to increase. That 50 becomes, let us suppose, some 75 electrons. Plus, whether that will be remain minority charge carrier, the 50 holes will remain same or it will increase or it will decrease. I have taken a intrinsic semiconductor. For that intrinsic semiconductor, I have added donor impurities. That intrinsic semiconductor contains 50 electrons plus 50 holes. You are adding a donor impurities, that one. So number of electrons are going to increase. That 50 became to 75. What happens to this number of holes? Will remain same or it will increase, it will decrease? Now see here, the number of electrons are increased. What is going to happen to recombination? Holes and electrons, some of the electrons which are generated may recombine with the holes already present. Therefore, this may become 40 electrons or 30 electrons. Clear? That means as the donor impurities are increased, the minority charge carriers, not electrons, not holes, minority charge carriers strength will be reduced. Here 50-50, this will increase, this will decrease if donor impurities are added. If acceptor impurities are added, holes will increase, electrons will decrease compared to intrinsic semiconductor. Therefore, it is inversely proportional to doping concentration. It is inversely proportional to doping concentration. Is clear? Once again, see here. At intrinsic semiconductor, number of electrons is equal to number of holes. That 50-50 I have taken. We have added donor type impurities. Donor impurities are added means number of electrons strength is going to increase, magnitude is going to increase. These induced electrons, some of the induced electrons may recombine with the existing holes. Therefore, the number of holes will be reduced if donor impurities are added. If acceptor impurities are added, the number of holes will increase, number of electrons will decrease. Therefore, always minority carriers will reduce. Okay. Therefore, answer is inversely proportional to doping concentration. It's not related on the intrinsic concentration. Okay, the next problem. A silicon sample, wait 1 minute. A silicon sample A, silicon sample A is doped with 10 power 18 atoms per centimeter cube of boron impurities. These are boron. That means the semiconductor becomes p-type. Therefore, sample A or semiconductor A is a p-type semiconductor since we are adding boron impurities. Okay, next, another sample B of identical dimensions, another sample B of identical dimensions is doped with 10 power 18, this also, atoms per centimeter cube of phosphorus atoms. Phosphorus atoms means it becomes an n-type semiconductor. Now the ratio, now the question is the ratio of electron, next, not question, continuation of the problem, the ratio of electron mobility to hole mobility, electron mobility to hole mobility is 3. Then find the ratio of conductivity of sample A to the conductivity of sample B. Conductivity of sample A to the conductivity of sample B. Now, its conductivity of A, it's a p-type semiconductor. Therefore, it is Na E mu p. Actual formula is N E mu N plus P mu plus P E mu P total, but it is now N type semiconductor, P type semiconductor. For N type semiconductor, P type semiconductor, this is the formula. Similarly, for a P type semiconductor, it is N D E mu N. This will cancel and is given N A and N D both are equal. See, 10 power 18. 10 power 18, both are equal, therefore it is also cancelled. So simply it is mu p by mu n. He is given mu n by mu p is 3, therefore answer is 1 by 3. Answer is 1 by 3. Next one, it's a theory question. A band gap of silicon at room temperature is dash. A band gap of silicon at room temperature, it's equals to 1.1 electron volt. At 0 degree Kelvin, it is 1.2. Okay, we have seen yesterday one formula, 1.21 minus 3.4 into 10 power minus 40. T is 0 at absolute 0, therefore 1.21. At room temperature, it is 1.1 electron volts. That is, T becomes 300 degree Kelvin. Next point. The resistivity of a uniformly doped, the resistivity of a uniformly doped n-type silicon sample is, resistivity of an n-type silicon sample is 0.5 ohm centimeter, 0.5 ohm centimeter. If the electron mobility, mobility of electron is equals to 1250 centimeter square per whole second. The charge of electron 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. Then donor impurity concentration is how much? Donor impurity concentration is dash. Now it is an n-type semiconductor. For an n-type semiconductor, conductivity is equals to E nd mu n. E is given, mu n is given, but conductivity is not known. We require mu n, mu not mu n, nd. We require nd. Nd equals to sigma n by E mu n. This sigma can be written as 1 by rho n E mu n. Rho is given, E is given, mu n is given, just direct substitution, you will get nd. Clear? Next point. All are similar type of problems. Okay, I am not taking these things. Next one. Under low level injection, under low level injection assumption, the injected minority carrier current, for an extrinsic semiconductor, is essentially dash. Once again, I am repeating, under low level injection assumption, the injected minority carrier current for an extrinsic semiconductor essentially is due to dash. Options are diffusion current, option B drift current, option C recombination current, option D induced current. Diffusion current, drift current, recombination current, induced current. Now, we know that total current density equals to current density due to diffusion plus current density due to drift mechanism. It is diffusion E dN dN by dx. Okay, now consider only due to electrons, example, maybe electrons or maybe holes, same thing is. This is N mu N nd. This diffusion depends on concentration gradient. Okay, now what is this one? It's impurities, donor impurities. This one is mobility. So these two not going to play any role in our problem. This is concentration, electron concentration. In the problem he said under low level injection, that means the number of carriers that are introduced are very small, that is n is very small. If n is very small, then we can neglect drift currents. Then Jn is approximately equals to J drift diffusion. Because n is a smaller quantity, therefore this entire thing is negligible in comparison to this one. Therefore it is E dN dN by dx, nothing but it is only due to diffusion current. Drift current is not considered because injection, number of electrons introduced, n concentration is less. Therefore n is negligible. Therefore it is only due to diffusion. Next one. A long specimen of p-type semiconductor material is, a long specimen of p-type semiconductor material is, options, electrically neutral, positive, electrically negative, electrically neutral, we can't say. Once again I am repeating, a long specimen of a p-type semiconductor material is, options are electrically positive, electrically negative, electrically neutral, we can't say. Already I said all the materials are without biasing, they are neutral. Either n-type semiconductor or p-type semiconductor or intrinsic semiconductor or metal or insulator, without application of external voltages, they are electrically neutral. So it's a p-type semiconductor is electrically neutral. Same n-type semiconductor, intrinsic semiconductor, metals, all are electrically neutral. Next one. The electron and hole concentration, the electron and hole concentration in a semiconductor are Ni and Pi respectively. The electron and hole concentration in a semiconductor are Ni and Pi respectively. When doped with a p-type material, the change to N and P, this Ni and Pi are changed to N and P, then which one of the following statement is true? Then which one of the following, which one of the following statement is true? Options are N plus P equals to Ni plus Pi, option B. N into Pi is equals to Ni into P, option C. N plus Ni is equals to P plus Pi, option D. Ni into Pi is equals to N into P. Now, I gave one statement. N into P equals to Ni square, mass action law. This mass action law is applicable for intrinsic semiconductor, n-type semiconductor, p-type semiconductor. Now, this is Ni plus Pi, Ni into Pi equals to Ni square if it is intrinsic semiconductor, Ni and Pi both are same. Okay, if it is an n-type semiconductor, if it is a p-type semiconductor, now, in intrinsic semiconductor, it's given it as Ni and Pi. When donor accept impurities are added, means it becomes, is given N and P instead of NPPP. Therefore, this and this are equal. Therefore, Ni into Pi equals to N into P. See, this one and this one. Therefore, answer is Ni into Pi equals to N into P. Next one. The electron concentration in a sample, the electron concentration in a sample of uniformly doped n-type silicon, the electron concentration in a sample of uniformly doped n-type silicon at 300 degree Kelvin varies linearly from 10 power 17 atoms per meter cube at x equals to 0. 6 into 10 power 16 atoms per centimeter cube at x equals to 2 micron. That means the electron concentration at x equals to 0, these many number of electrons are there. At x equals to 2 micron, these many number of electrons are there. Now what is the meaning of his given statement? Concentration gradient existed. One side more number, other side less number. Therefore automatically movement of carriers takes place. Okay, that's first. We'll check it. Okay. Next. Assume a situation that electrons are supplied to keep this concentration gradient constant with respect to time. That means if the electrons are moving from one side to other side, to maintain that after some time thermal equilibrium is reached, no movement of the carriers takes place. That's normally. But what is in this problem is doing continuously pumping the electrons from the outside, from the external source pumping is done in order to maintain the concentration gradient, so that continuously there is a movement of electrons from high concentration area to low concentration area. Okay, with dN diffusion constant 35 centimeter square per second, the charge of electron 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. Then current density in a silicon if no electric field is present is dash. If no electric field is present, then dash. That means is asking to find out J and is given electric field is zero. One more statement is given in the problem. We know that total current density J equals to J drift plus J diffusion. What is J drift formula? N mu n E plus P mu P E into E. But is given in this problem, this is 0. Therefore, this is 0. That means total current density is due to only diffusion. That is J diffusion. And J diffusion due to electrons plus J diffusion due to holes. But in the problem, he not mention anything about the holes. So only due to electrons. So J diffusion due to electrons because holes are not given. So the formula is E dN dN by dx. What is E? 1.6 into 10 power minus 19. dN 35. All are in centimeters only, directly you can use. dN, N2 minus N1 you can use. N2 is 6 into 10 power 16 minus N1 10 power 17 divided by N2 2 into 10 power minus 6 meters. But all are in centimeters. Therefore take it as 2 into 10 power minus 4 centimeters minus 0. Okay, this we are writing it as 2 into 10 power minus 4 centimeters. Okay, now find out this one, you will get minus sign. See here, this is a smaller quantity, this is a larger quantity. Minus of, I think you are going to get it as minus 1120 ampere per centimeter square is the answer. Ampere per centimeter square is the answer. Clear? Next. next problem. There is one interesting problem is there, that's I'm searching 1 minute. The resistance of a copper wire, of diameter, 1 mm, length 300 meters is 6.5 ohms. So, given the resistance, if the free electron concentration is 8.4 into 10 power 28 electrons per meter cube. Current is 2 amperes. Then calculate, conductivity. Okay. He is given diameter, length, resistance, then its electron concentration, N, not efficiency, electron concentration, and is given current. Now, he asked to find out conductivity. Conductivity is 1 by rho resistivity. Resistivity equals to R L by A. R is given, okay, L is given. What about area? Area is not given. For that purpose is given diameter. Since diameter is given, radius equals to diameter by 2, that is 0.5 mm. Now, he is given in a problem, copper wire. It is a circular one. In that case, area equals to, area of a circle is pi r square. Pi r 0.5 into 10 power minus 6 whole square. Therefore, area is known directly substitute. Why I have taken this problem means, he is not given area directly, he is given diameter. From using the diameter, we have to use, calculate the area by using pi r square basic formula. Okay, next problem. A silicon cylindrical wire of length 20 meters and the cross-sectional area 10 power minus 1 centimeter square is doped with boron impurities with a ratio of 1:10^6 If the atomic density of silicon is 5×10^22 atoms per centimeter cube, 5×10^22 atoms per centimeter cube. Intrinsic concentration is 1.5×10^10 atoms per centimeter cube. Hole mobility is 500 centimeter square per volt second. Then calculate carrier concentrations. Calculate resistance C bit. Calculate current if electric field of 10 volts per centimeter is applied. The given data, length is given, area is given, here see the small difference. All are in centimeters except this. Convert this into centimeters. Boron impurities is given, density of silicon atoms, intrinsic concentration, mobility of holes is given, then carrier concentration. Carrier concentration means you ask to find out N, you ask to find out P. Then resistance and current. Now, we are adding boron impurities. Therefore, thus it becomes semiconductor, intrinsic semiconductor becomes a P-type semiconductor. For a P-type semiconductor, we know that NP, PP equals to Na square, then PP equals to Na, then NP equals to Na square by PP, that is Na square by Na. So hole concentration is equals to donor acceptability concentration. Electron concentration equals to using this formula. Now what is Na? Whether is given? Yes. How much is given? Is given ratio. Boron impurities are added 1:10^6. Is given silicon density. Density of silicon atoms. Yeah. That is, see, 5×10^22 atoms are there. How many boron impurities are added? For 10^6, what is the meaning of 10^6 means? For 10^6 atoms, one boron impurity. This is silicon, this is boron. For 10^6 silicon atoms, one boron atom is added. Like that 5×10^22 silicon atoms are there, how many boron impurities are asked to be added? In all the previous problems, it's given directly. In this problem, it's given indirectly. That's all. So this is 5×10^22 by 10^6. This is nothing but acceptor impurities, nothing but boron impurities. So you are going to get it 16 atoms per centimeter cube. Clear? Once you got this one, this is over. Then Ni is given, then you can calculate the Np. Then resistance R equals to rho L by A. L is given, A is given. Rho you have to calculate it. How to calculate rho? Rho equals to 1 by conductivity. The formula for conductivity equals to, it's an entire P-type semiconductor. Therefore, Na E mu P. Na calculated, E known, mu p given. So can you able to calculate this one or not? Once you know J, conductivity, rho equals to, once you know rho, you can able to calculate the resistance. Like this, using this one, calculate sigma, calculate rho, substitute here, find out the resistance. It's clear? Next one. He asked to find out I. We know J, current density, equals to sigma into E, Ohm's law. Sigma into E. Sigma calculated, E given, J. What is J? J is nothing but I by A equals to sigma into E. Therefore, I equals to sigma into E into A. Calculated sigma, E given 10. Yeah, 10. A given, calculated. Can you able to calculate I or not? You can able to calculate I. It's clear? Like this, the only compared to previous problems, is not given directly how many impurities are added. That's why I taken this problem. It's a little bit interesting. Next. Next problem. In a semiconductor, what should be the concentration of free electrons? What should be the concentration of free electrons so that conductivity is maximum. Once again, I am repeating, in a semiconductor, what should be the concentration of free electrons so that conductivity is maximum? We know conductivity is n mu n e plus p mu p e. This is conductivity. Equation number one. What is asking? Calculate the concentration of free electrons so that conductivity is maximum. When will be the conductivity is maximum? Means, dou, it's with respect to electrons. So, dou sigma by dou n, find out when it is zero. When it will become zero. That V is going to give dou, okay? To find the value of n, conductivity should be, is given maximum, okay? Maximum means dou sigma by dou n has to be 0. This is given. We know that ni square equals to n into p. This p can be written as ni square by n, equation number 3. Substitute 3 in 1. Sigma equals to n, we require mu n, keep it as it is, e, keep it as it is, p. Ni square by n, mu p, e. Equation number 4. Differentiate this equation with respect to number of electrons. That is, differentiating equation 4 with respect to n, mu n, e. Then minus n square by n square into mu p into e. This is 0 for maximum, that is mu n e minus n square by n square into mu p into e. E e will cancel, so it can be written, okay, mu n into e equals to n square by n square into mu p. E will cancel, so we require n square. N square equals to n square mu p by mu n. So n equals to n square mu p by mu n. N equals to ni into square root of mu p by mu n. This is the concentration of electrons for the conductivity should have a maximum. Similarly, if you want electron concentration, in that case, dou sigma by dou p equals to 0. Then we know that ni square equals to n into p, then n equals to ni square by p. If you substitute there, you will get same way, p equals to ni into square root of mu n by mu p. In some of the problems, he will give this one, ask to calculate the carrier concentration for the conductivity should be maximum. In that case, you have to use the formula. So, we will do one or two problems based on this one, okay, depending on the thing. Now, we will have a break. After break, we will continue.